Hi students, today we are discussing about mean value theorems in differentiation. There are two mean value theorems. One is introduced by Prouhl's and other is introduced by Lagrange's. In such a situation, mean value theorem is applicable. Let us discuss the two theorems. First one is Prouhl's theorem. Prouhl's theorem states that if f be a real function defined in the closed interval AB, if be a real function f means f of x. Be a real function defined in the closed interval AB. We have studied the intervals in the plus one class. Closed interval means all values in between A and B, including K and including B, that is closed interval. If a function f of x is defined in the closed interval AB, then first condition is f is continuous in the closed interval AB, in the closed interval AB. Second condition is f is derivable in the open interval AB. F is derivable means differentiable. We can find the derivative of f of x. That is known as derivable function. F is derivable in the open interval AB. And third condition is f of a is equal to f of b. If these conditions satisfy, then we can say that the function satisfy Prouhl's theorem. Then there x is a constant. There x is a constant. That constant is known as c, such that f dash c is equal to 0. If we have f dash x here, if a function is derivable means we can find its derivative, we get f dash here. In f dash x, put x is equal to c, we get f dash c. If it equates, f dash c is equal to 0. Then we get the value of c, and that c lies in between where c lies in between the open interval A. That constant, the existing constant c, lies in between the open interval A B, means it is in between A and B. That is known as Prouhl's theorem. Isn't it? Mean value theorem states that Lagrange's mean value theorem. In short, we can say that LMV theorem. In Lagrange's mean value theorem, if f be a real function defined in the closed interval AB, then f is continuous in the closed interval AB. If it is derivable in the open interval AB, we need only these two conditions. Then there x is a constant c, such that f dash c is equal to f of b minus f of a divided by b minus a. In Rolle's theorem, the constant is obtained by putting f dash c is equal to 0. But in Weinberg theorem, c, the constant c, is obtained by putting the values in this equation, that is f dash c is equal to f of b minus f of a divided by b minus a. The difference between Rolle's and Lagrange's are, in Rolle's theorem, symmetrical curves are used. Symmetrical curves means the ordinate and b are same. In the case of Rolle's theorem, suppose the curve is like this. Here, this distance, a and b are same. Suppose we have a curve like this. For Rolle's theorem, the curve is like this. Here, the ordinates are same, f of a and f of b are same. F of a is equal to f of b in the case of Rolle's theorem. But in the case of mean value theorem, suppose the curve is like this. Here, the ordinates are not equal. Here f of a is not equal to f of b, isn't it? If the curve is symmetrical, then Rolle's theorem is better. If the curve is non-symmetrical, then Rolle's theorem fails. There, mean value theorem can be applied, isn't it? Let us discuss some examples. Applicability of Rolle's theorem. First question is, f of x is equal to, in 1, 3. Since f of x is a polynomial function, it is continuous everywhere. All polynomial functions are continuous everywhere. First condition is, since f of x is a polynomial, it is continuous in the closed interval 1, 3. In the closed interval 1, 3, this function is a continuous function because it is a polynomial. Second condition is, find f dash x. Here f dash x is 2x minus 4 into 1 plus 0, that is 2x minus 4. We can find the derivative of this function. Therefore, f of x is derivable, is a derivable function, derivable in the open interval 1, 3. In the open interval 1, 3, the function is derivable. Now, one more condition is there. Third condition is f of a. Here, f of a is series 1. Substituting the value of 1 in f of x, we have 1 square minus 4 into 1 plus 3, 1 minus 4 minus, sorry, plus 3 is equal to 0. And f of b is equal to f of 3, that is 3 square minus 4 into 3 plus 3, 9 plus 3, 12 minus 12 is equal to 0. All these conditions satisfy. Therefore, their x is a constant. C such that f dash c is equal to 0. F dash c is equal to 0. Here f dash c is put x is equal to c here, that is 2c minus 4c equal to 0. 2c is equal to 4c is equal to, which is in between 1, 3. The constant c lies in between 1 and 3. Hence, we can verify Rolle's theorem. Rolle's theorem is verified. In this way, we can verify Rolle's theorem, isn't it? Let us discuss with another question. F of x of c equal to cos 2x in 0, 5. F of x is equal to cos 2x in 0, 5. Trigonometric functions or t functions are continuous everywhere. Continuous functions means curve maintains a continuity. Sine function is a sine function. Cos function like this. All these functions maintain a continuity. Therefore, cos 2x is a t function, therefore it is continuous. Or since f of x is a t function, it is continuous in the closed interval 0, 5. Isn't it? Now we can find its derivative f dash s. F dash s is cos 2x is minus sin 2x into 2x is 2. So its derivative is minus 2 sin 2x. Minus 2 sin 2x is its derivative. Therefore, f of x is the derivable function in the interval, open interval 0, 5. In 0, 5, this function is a derivable function. F of a, here f of a is equal to f of 0. Substituting cos 2 into 0, that is cos 0 is 1. F of pi is cos 2 into pi. Cos 2 pi is also 1. Cos 2 pi is 1. Cos 0 is 1. Cos 2 pi is 1. Cos 4 pi is 1. Cos 6 pi is 1. Even multiples of pi are 1 in the case of cos. Then there exists a constant c such that f dash c is equal to 0. Here f dash c is equal to minus 2 sin 2x 2c is equal to 0, which implies that minus 2 is a constant, so sin 2c is equal to 0. If sin 2c is equal to 0, therefore 2c is equal to 0, pi, 2, pi, etc. Therefore, we can say that c is equal to 0 by 2 is 0, pi by 2, 2 pi by 2 is pi, comma, etc. Now we have to find the value of c in between 0 and pi. In 0 and pi, c is pi by 2, which implies that c is equal to pi by 2. This value is only applicable. C is pi by 2, which is in between the open interval of 0. Hence, we can verify the Rolle's theorem. Follow this. Let us discuss one more question. F of x is equal to sin x minus sin 2x in 0 by the same interval 0. First case, f of x is a t function, so it is continuous in the interval 0 by. This step is same as in the previous case. F dash x is The reality of science is cosines minus sine 2x is 2 cos 2x. Function of a function. Sine 2x is cos 2x. 2x is 2. 2 cos 2x. Therefore, f of x is derived in the open interval 0. Now, third condition is f of a is f of 0. F of 0 is sin 0 minus sin 2 into 0, that is 0, sin 0 is 0, sin pi minus sin 2 pi, sin pi 0, sin 2 pi 0, sin 3 pi 0, therefore it is 0. Therefore, third condition, f of a is equal to f of b. We have f of a is equal to f of b. Third condition is also satisfied. Then there exists a constant c such that f dash c is equal to 0. Here, f dash c is equal to cos c minus 2 cos 2 c is equal to 0. But cos 2c is cos c minus 2 into cos 2c is 2 cos square c minus 1 is equal to 0. Removing the bracket, we have cos c minus 4 cos square c minus into minus plus 2 is equal to 0. Or multiplying both by minus 1, we have 4 cos square c minus cos c minus 2. Minus 2 is equal to 0. Second running equation. So a is equal to 4, b is equal to minus 1, c is equal to minus 2. Therefore, cos c is equal to minus b plus or minus root of b square minus 4ac by 2a. Here minus b is plus 1, plus or minus root of b square is 1 minus 4 into 4 into minus 2 divided by 2 into 4. Here is equal to 1 plus or minus root of 1 plus 32 divided by 8. Therefore, cos is equal to 1 plus or minus root of 33 by 8. Therefore, c is equal to cos inverse. Here we get two values, cos inverse 1 plus or minus root of 33 by 8. These values lies in between 0 and 5. Hence verify Rogge's theorem. Hence verify Rogge's theorem. In this way, we can verify the Rogge's theorem. Now, let us do some examples of Lagrange's theorem. First question is 2x minus x square in a closed interval 0, 1. Here also, f of x is a polynomial function. So it is continuous in the closed interval 0, 1. Now find the flash x. The flash x is 2 into 1 minus 2x, that is 2 minus 2x. Therefore, f of x is a derivable function in the open interval 0, 1. We need only these two conditions for mean value theorem. Now, if these two conditions are satisfied, then their x is a constant. See, such that f dash c is equal to f of b minus f of a divided by b minus a. Here f dash c is 2 minus 2c. F of b, here f of b is equal to f of 1, that is 2 into 1 minus 1 square, that is 2 minus 1 is 1, and f of a is equal to f of 0, 2 into 0 minus 0 square, so it is 0. So f of b is 1 minus 0 divided by b minus a is also 1 minus 0. So 2c, 2 minus 2c is equal to 1 by 1 is 1. Here 2 minus 1 is equal to 2c, or c is equal to 1 by 2, which is in between 0 and 1. The constant c lies in between 0 and 1. Therefore, c is the constant, hence we can verify the Lagrange's mean value theorem. Isn't it? Hence, LMB theorem is verified. Let us discuss with one more question. F of x is x plus 1 by x in 1. Here, f of x is a rational function. Therefore, rational function is continuous in 1 and 3. A rational function. Rational functions are studied in class 11. Rational functions are continuous. It is continuous in the interval, closed interval 1. Now f dash x is, derivative x is 1 plus minus 1 by x square, that is 1 minus 1 by x square. Therefore f of x is derivable in the open interval 1. Then there x is a constant c, such that f dash c is equal to f of b minus f of a divided by b minus a. We can find f of a and f of b here. F of b is f of 3. Here f of b is equal to f of 3. F of 3 is 3 plus 1 by 3. F of a is equal to f of 1, that is 1 plus 1 by 3. Sorry, 1 plus 1 by 1, that is 2. Now applying these values here, 1 minus 1 by c square is equal to here 3 plus 1 by 3 minus 2 divided by 3 c square cross multiplying c square minus 1 by c square is equal to here 1 plus 1 by 3 is 4 by 3. 4 by 3 by 2, 3 comes in the denominator, 4 by 3 into 2, that is 2 by 3. Now cross multiplying we have 3 into c square minus 1 is equal to 2 c square. So 3 c square minus 3 is equal to c square. 3 c square minus 2 c square is equal to 3. C square is equal to 3. Therefore, c is equal to root of 3, which is in between 1 and 3. The constant c is equal to root 3, which is in between 1 and 3. Hence, we can verify mean value theorem. Hence, LMB theorem is verified. I think you will get a clear idea about the mean value theorems of rods and leg branches. Now you collect some questions from the question papers or the text and do it yourself. Thank you.